Welcome class to Advanced Composition. As we begin this year, I'd like to lay some ground rules for this course. Late grades are absolutely unacceptable, and I will not take them under any circumstance. So let's begin our day by talking about what your first assignment is going to be. Isaac,
yeah.
You're late.
Yeah.
That's unacceptable. First day behavior, not acceptable. Okay, so as we return to talking about what your assignment is going to be, your first day, I'd like to have you write about your life. Where do you see yourself in 15 years? Imagine what you'll be doing. Imagine who you will be.
When I finally got my paper done 2 days early and at double the minimum word count, I was so proud of it that I had to show everyone. My parents both proofread it half a dozen times. I emailed it to my grandma. I even read it to my dog a few times.
Hey nerd, how's your paper going?
Oh, I just finished it last night.
Oh really?
Dude, what are you doing?
No. My paper.
Oh my God.
My paper it's gone. I emailed it to my grandma. Oh my God. I still have a chance.
When grandma finally answered her phone, it quickly became apparent that she didn't have the computer know-how to send it back. The only option, it seemed, was to drive all the way to Oklahoma and back after school to pick it up. But I didn't have a car. After a dozen desperate phone calls to classmates with cars, and being rejected a dozen times, I was faced with the hardest decision of my life. I could give up on my paper and my perfect 4.0 GPA, or I could ask for help from the only person I hadn't called yet. Isaac was not the kind of kid I would normally associate with, or occasionally associate with, or ever associate with at all. Last year, he spent every day asleep during U.S. history, and never turned in a single assignment all year. Rumor had it that he had managed to fail freshman PE 2 years prior.
So what's this paper supposed to be about?
We're gonna say the grades we have in that class, and mine's gonna be better. Promise. Ready?
66!
What?
After crossing the Oklahoma state line, the roads got bumpy, and the people got pretty terrifying. The speed limit down there is 70, but we were the only people driving under 80. We decided to take a snack break at a dirty-looking gas station.
So for the paper, truck.
Like, if I want to say, excuse us,
I want to say Democrats or liberals.
Which one would I say?
I'd say Democrats.
Democrats are better?
I think so, yeah.
Okay, yeah. Democrats.
You hear what he said?
Something about Democrats being better.
Get in the truck.
Grandma? Don't forget, quilting meeting at 11 o'clock. Okay, if I were my grandma, where would I put my computer? Is that? Oh, yes! Oh my god. Grandma!
The truck from the gas station? What are they doing here? Oh no.
Bro, we gotta go.
What's wrong?
Those rednecks.
What rednecks?
From the gas station.
Okay, I printed the
paper. They followed us here.
I printed the paper.
Go.
After we lost the rednecks, we got out of Oklahoma as fast as Isaac's car would take us. The next day, we were both anxious and excited to turn in our papers. I was 15 minutes early, and to my surprise, Isaac was on time.
Well, gentlemen, I actually extended the deadline till next week.
What?
I sent you an email. Didn't you get it?
Next week?
Next week.